the mask transition has the ability to take you from one location to somewhere completely different, sometimes in the blink of an eye. I did all of these with the new Filmora 9, and if you want to learn how to do them too, stick around. I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
The mask transition is a fairly advanced effect, but you can do this in Filmora with the right footage and a little patience. The first thing you need is a piece of footage that has some object that moves completely across the screen from one side all the way to the other, and that stretches from the very top of the screen to the bottom. I'm using some stock footage of a forest that has a tree, which will work perfectly. I brought that into Filmora and found exactly where that tree made its move. Once I found where it began, I stretched the timeline out as far as it would go, so I was looking at the footage one frame at a time. I split the footage right where that tree began, exposing what was on the right of it. Then I moved one frame at a time, splitting the footage at each frame until the tree was out of sight. If you've done the same with your footage, up in the left-hand corner, you'll want to click on Sample Colors and find the stock green color sample that Filmora provides. Bring that down onto the track above the other footage and start it right at your first splice point. Move one frame at a time to the right and slice it again. Now you'll have a single frame of green screen. Start by locking your main footage in place, then put your playhead on the very first green screen frame and click on it up in the preview window. Now you want to drag the green screen layer from the left over towards the right. What we're doing here is we're trying to cover anything that's to the right of the tree. Line that green layer up with the right side of the tree and move the playhead forward to the next frame. Repeat the same process, and you'll want to do this till each one of your frames has everything covered to the right of your tree, or whatever you choose as your masking point. Now take your last green frame and stretch it out a little bit to make it a little longer. You now have a mask track. Let's export that and then bring it back into Filmora. Find your next piece of footage that you want to transition into and bring that down in your timeline. Put your new mask footage right above it. Line up your footage so that the new footage begins just before the mask transition starts, and then double left click on the mask layer. Up in the left, click on Video, and then in the Chroma key dropdown, activate that function by putting a check mark next to it. It should default to green, so you can now dial in your green screen to allow the track below it to show through. Use the offset, tolerance, edge thickness, and edge feather to make the transition line as smooth as possible. This was an easy one because the tree was fairly vertical and a straight mask line did the trick. In this next one, the post that goes by the train window was a little crooked. So in a situation like this, we want to slightly tilt the green screen mask so that it lines up with the angle of the object. Then just repeat for each frame just like we did before with the tree. Export that footage, bring it back in, and now you'll have a mask track ready to go there as well. The jet fighter scene was a little more advanced. I had found this stock footage of a fighter jet on a green screen set. I put it above my footage of the trees passing by, but when I activated the chroma key, I could see the trees in front of the jet and behind the jet. I wanted to do a cloud effect behind the jet, so I had to add one more step. The way I handled that was to watch the footage of the jet, and this time I cut the background footage below it one frame at a time as the tail of the jet passed through the frame. I then inserted my green screen track between the jet and the background footage and cut each frame on that track to match the background footage slices. Frame by frame, I moved the jet across the screen and lined up my green screen so that everything behind the jet would look green. This took some patience, but once that was done, I turned off the track with the jet in it and exported the other two tracks to create my masked background footage. I brought that back into Filmora, and now I had a background shot that was perfectly masked off behind the jet. Now here's the cool part. I brought a third track of clouds and put that as the lowest track. I put the new mask background track above that one and then left that green screen jet at the very top. Three layers. I activated the chroma key feature for the top two layers, then the jet layer allowed everything around it to show through. The background layer underneath it only allowed what was masked off from behind the jet to show through, and that gave me the sky and clouds. I put them all together and voila!